fine.
Introduce the players.
Why not? So, here we are at IGA 23, and this is the second semifinals. Geneli is currently leading 1-0, and Geneli is obviously the pink Protoss, and he's spawning at the left side position. And against him is BH Master, the Teal Terran, which is our three-time consecutive winner of the last three IGAs. With me is Zoker, and we're on ESL Shakura's Platoon.
Just going back to what we've said earlier, apparently ESL Shakura's is not only cross positions.
Yep. Apparently I was hardly mistaken on that. But chances were in my favor when I thought about it. So maybe it's ESV Shakura's Plateau? I'm almost sure one Shakura's Plateau is only cross position. It's apparently ESV. And now Geneli correctly scouting positions, the right position. Gonna try to take down another SCV. Forces BH Master to pull it. And a bit of miss micro there.
he tried the same thing he did last game, but BH Master saw it and killed the probe.
Yep. I don't know if Geneli managed to spot the second gas. Yeah, he did. He did spot it and he didn't see any refinery. So he thinks currently it's one Rex expansion, and apparently it is. We see BH Master staking out a lot of minerals, so it's gonna be probably one Rex expansion. Meanwhile, Geneli is still not opted for his tech or economy build.
This is probably the most common Terran build versus Protoss.
Excuse me, can you repeat that?
I said this is probably the most common build in this matchup, going gasless expand, especially on this map.
Yeah.
I mean, it's very easy to hold up any aggression put on by the Protoss if you put Bunker above this ramp, going up to the natural.
I really feel like TVP in the early stages is dictated by the Terran. Like, the Terran decides what he wants to do, and then the Protoss reacts. Obviously the Protoss can say, alright, if I spot no gas, I'm going for proxy Stargate and three gates with it. But it's definitely decided by the Terran's actions. Like, you're always taking... It's you who need to do the scouting rather than the Terran. You can react to it, but Terran definitely dictates the early games.
I agree.
So Eamon's expansion going into effect as immediately as of BH Master, but of course we see the bunker go up and Deathstalker will have to retreat. Nice timing from BH Master, which also saves an SCV. Which now unloads and makes room for another Marine. We see a reactor on the barracks. We're gonna see a lot of Marines soon. And once again, we see two refineries with only two SCVs mining from them.
Trademark BH Master.
Two more gates for Geneli, which will have the total sum of three gates. And an expansion going up right now. Another tech lab and a third barracks for BH.
Yep, and it's going to be Stimpax first, not Combat Shield this time.
Which is, again, sometimes most players will prefer having Stim, maybe because of that bunker. Marines can steam. You know what, maybe it's because of the Marauder. Marauder does not gain anything from steam, from combat shields obviously, but from steam he can do a lot of damage. No concussive shields yet. We see a robotics facility for Geneli.
only going here for a 3-gate row, but I'm pretty sure he's going to make Colossus after this.
We see Geneli almost lose a Stalker at the middle. Harvester's count is dead even on 33 Harvesters for both of them, which means BH Master is ahead because of Mules. I would really like to see Concussive Shells on the way. Those really make the difference against Zealots. We see a factory for BH Master and an engineering bay, opting for those upgrades.
Yep, going three gases now. You will begin to make the starport immediately after the factory, and possibly get an upgrade or two.
Meanwhile, Geneli is going immortal and then a quick observer afterwards. Meanwhile, no robotics bay, so no colossi production. We didn't see Geneli's path just yet. Another gateway added on. Combat shields halfway done already. And plus one weapons for the infantry. Now we see Geneli pushes up to the middle of the map. And I've lost my mouse cursor. Alright, I'm getting it back. Don't ask me how I just did it. We see a Twilight Council for Geneli, so he's opting for either fast chargelots or blink. And I really wouldn't push with that force without me seeing what's going on over there. And Geneli is just poking up the ramp, realizing I cannot take it, and forces and go away.
Okay, so Geneli actually doing the same thing he did first game versus, was it T-Rex, I think? Yeah, he made a robotic facility going straight for charge and double forge.
And the first game he didn't go so well, if I remember correctly. I wonder if this game will show him better results. BH Master currently leading in Harvester's count, and that means his economy is also better since of Mules. I will keep reminding of the Mules because it's such a pain for me as a Protoss player to see how much effective Mules are, simply changing the entire economy in Terran's favor.
Look at the... See, BH Master moving out across the middle of the map. He's going to get the plus one weapons upgrade really soon, and the concussive shell is following. We have to see, maybe he's going to go for a drop, maybe he's going to pressure the front. And yeah, we see two medivacs loading up.
Mm-hmm.
And he's going for a drop in the back of Geneli's base.
Also see Geneli that he have stalkers placed for both a drop and elevator play at the ledge of the cliff here. Which I've stated that might happen. These stalkers seem like well positioned for the drop right now. I wonder if they can take the medivacs out. Wonder when he'll spot him. He should now spot him and also spot the main force. And he's retreating with the stalkers while the main force will attack at the natural. BH Master is a pretty good spot at the behind the minerals and attacking at the front at the same time. Garden Shield goes up and those chargelots are opting to die rather quickly to those in the Bioball. Meanwhile at the natural, the main all mining has been seized and GG from Geneli.